This place is great, Sindri. You built it all yourself?
You know it. See? I knew you wanted a snack.
Hey, come see. I guess this is where they store the food. Nice to have options if I wake up hungry.
Finding everything all right, I hope?
How do we unlock the realms?
We'll just need something from back at the workshop. Follow me, and be sure to bring the head. So, where exactly is Tyr being held?
He's imprisoned in a mine somewhere. That's all we know so far.
The realm is full of mines, you realize. You'll need help narrowing it down. Oh, you should talk to Durlin.
Who's Durlin?
He's a cousin of ours, sort of. Works for the city on safety issues. Should have access to all kinds of information on mines. And I know he's no friend of Odin. That's why your mother sought his help when she was trying to whip up a rebellion. Ready?
A rebellion? Did you know about that?
I did not.
A rebel leader who knew Mom. Sounds like exactly what we need.
I think you missed the ta-da. Well, never mind. I'll have this oiled up in no time. Meet you at the gateway outside.
Rebel leader? Durlin? That ain't giving a hound a haircut.
Huh?
And you just remember things however they pop into your being. Don't you?
Atreus.
All right. See you out there, Sindri. You hear that? Are those some kind of dragons? They're so far, I can't tell how big they are.
We'll just need the Bifrost in the head. Brock?
Do the touching.
Oh, this would be the part requiring my assistance, then.
You said it. This device here has been crafted to your measurements. It'll help you get a better look at the problem with those Bifrost eyes of yours.
So, do I control this thing somehow, then?
Oh, no. This is just to hold you in place while we shine this light in your eyes.
Oh, Sindri, you starting bastard!
Open now. I was really hoping not to use the eyelid clamps.
Do it.
That's it. Good. Now, release.
Still unpleasant.
That's our cue. Come on, hurry!
I'm coming!
Frostwalker's eggs, man! What was that for?
You'll see soon enough. I need to adjust. There! That should do it. See? No permanent damage.
I'll show you permanent damage, you wee fuck! Kratos! Throw me at him! Horns first!
Case you takes a joke, you old goat!
The Bifrost is broken.
Now that we've reconfigured these gateways to use Yggdrasil seeds, you won't need a travel table or a Bifrost lamp anymore.
I also used it for light.
Okay, good note. I'll figure something out, but first, come on, let me show you how it works. Aim your key at the rune for Svartalfheim on the right, then concentrate. This should take you to the wetlands outside Nidavellir City. Just make your way to the town square and ask for Derlin at the tavern.
You sure they'll know him at the tavern?
Derlin's always been an inveterate inebriate. I suppose he might have completely changed, but in my experience, eh.
Did you want to come with us?
Oh, I might drop in, but the wetlands are moist. And the Grim are everywhere. Hostile, slimy, foul-smelling creatures. But good luck!
Thanks. Wait, what?
I said good luck!
Whoa! Do you feel that?
What's that? What?
Anything. Everything. It's warm. We can probably use this boat. If I can just get it free.
Careful, lad.
Ah! Why are these things so fast?
Already off to a lively start.
Atreus, you dropped your guard.
I got the boat free, though. I still can't believe Mom led a whole rebellion here against Odin and never talked about it.
The fact that it didn't go well might have cut that notion.
What your mother did before we met was her business.
Did you ever ask?
Eyes on the water. They are resources.
If you never asked Mom about what she used to do, what did you talk about when you met? Like, did you just say...
Woman, guard the house. I will go to catch fish in the river.
And then leave for 5 days?
No. Your mother was far better at fishing than I.
Did you see that over there?
That wheel is blocking the channel.
I imagine if you can turn it, we should be able to get through.
So these are wetlands, huh? Pretty accurate.
It is a bog.
The smell is making my eyes burn.
You know, it is a fair bit more potent than when I last visited, now that you mention it.
Looks like the path continues on the other side of that geyser. If only we were in Midgard. That water'd be frozen in a second. Think that's sturdy enough to climb?
Aye. Good old dwarven craftsmanship.
Tyr was a friend to the giants. I wonder if he and Mom ever met. If he was a part of the rebellion here.
It's certainly possible. The god of war often advocated for the giants. Although I don't recall if he ever declared allegiance outright.
Okay, there's got to be some way to turn the wheel up here.
Well there! Give a man some warning if he's about to suddenly end up snout deep in cheek.
The ground.
Was that an earthquake?
An occasional but not unheard of happenstance in Spartalfheim. With all the mining here, the land's bound to be a wee bit bothered.
I was thinking, because it's so warm, maybe it's not that the cold hasn't made it here yet, but maybe it's just different in Spartalfheim?
Aye, lad. Fimble Winter doesn't strike all realms quite the same way.
Weird that Fimble Winter doesn't always make it winter.
In Midgard it does, but as you can see, the effects here appear far more gaseous in nature. Observe the geysers. Observe the aforementioned aroma. These effects were present before in some form, but now there's new extremity to them.
Go! Behind you! Look out!
Father, he's there. Find anything good up there? Moving, but the water doesn't reach. Things are everywhere. Okay, he froze one of those geysers. Is there another one somewhere? Yes! The wheel's moving and the gate's coming down.
That's dwarven ingenuity for you.
Back to the boat.
If the dwarves of this realm are anything like Brock and Sindri, it's hard to imagine them siding with Odin.
Well, all too often people are blinded to all but their immediate self-interest. Odin offered them safety, and defying him can be quite dangerous.
Maybe they just need a couple of gods to come along and take the fight to him.
Atreus, that is not why we are here.
I was only joking.
War is not a joke, especially where gods are concerned.
Yikes. This place is wrecked. And yes, I am staying alert. There are probably tons of those Grimm around.
Go!
Atreus, you intend to recruit Tyr as an ally for war.
I'm trying to keep our options open. Let's just keep moving. I'm glad we're out here, exploring a new realm. Maybe we could just try to enjoy the warmth? Looks like we gotta find a way to open that gate if we want to get to Nidavellir.
Then how shall we catch it?
Flank it. Attack from behind.
Good.
Gotta get behind it. But how? Father, up there. Halfway there. There's gotta be another chain to lower the rest of the gate.
Go!
It's clinging to the wall! We gotta knock it down!
Behind you, brother!
You can uncover that geyser from here?
Go!
Oh, I think I get it. If you freeze the geyser, the pressure will turn the wheel. Block's coming down. Is there something else we can hit?
Maybe you could try hitting the rope holding the block. Maybe you could try hitting the rope holding the block.
I still don't see how we can get up to that chain.
Maybe you could try hitting the rope holding the block. Maybe you could try hitting the rope holding the block.
Nista! Nice one. Can you see anything from that block?
That's one of Cavassier's poems. Very highbrow. You should collect any others you find. Lad, if I may. What exactly are you hoping to learn from Tyr?
Well, like I said, I was hoping he could tell me something about Loki. I'd also like to hear some of his stories. Traveling to other lands, giant stuff, and maybe about what it was like to fight back in the day. Just for the history, obviously.
History?
Let's hope Tyr's in a talkative mood after being imprisoned for so long. Not all of Odin's captives can be as charmingly voluble as myself.
We have no proof Tyr is truly here.
Right. That earthquake earlier. Do you think there will be another one?
It's unlikely, but geological disturbances tend to be unpredictable.
If the geysers and smell here are worse because of Fimbulwinter, maybe the earthquakes are too?
Aye. You might be onto something, lad.
Atreus, look ahead.
Wow. Now this looks like a city.
Welcome to Nidavellir, brothers.
Hey, dwarf! Oh. They're, running away.
An alarm.
I'd only sound an alarm like that if I still had my body and was fearing the notion of being detached from it.
Why all that for us, though?
They are scared.
Most definitely an alarm, I'm afraid.
Why is everybody hiding?
Stay alert.
Hey, could we talk to you
for... We don't want any trouble, please.
There'll be no help, to be sure. Best we find the tavern Sindri mentioned on our own, and hope they let us in.
Is that a statue of Odin? They must really love him here.
Or fear him.
Sindri!
Hello. I'd return your surprise, but I did know you'd be here. I've got something for you.
I knew he'd left something behind.
Take your time.
What is it, dwarf?
You know, I'm glad I came back here at least once before Ragnarok. Oh, if these cobblestones could talk. Then they'd have mouths. Filthy, disgusting mouths. Do you mind if I fiddle with your bow? Oof, you are long overdue for a replacement.
Taking advantage of certain material... Ow! Structural sensitivity to sonic vibrations has been something... I've been meaning to try for quite some time now.
Thanks for, finally trying it. What's it gonna be this time?
Patience! I find it's best to see these things... in action! Whew.
There. Oh, take aim at that gate there. But before you loose, say, Skialfa. Skialfa.
Well, I certainly didn't expect you to disturb half the creepy crawlies in Nidavellir.
How was I supposed to know they were there?
Oh.
Okay, so, Derlin, Gotham. Sindri, any idea where the tavern is?
Do I look like I've ever been to a filthy tavern? The sewer you just punched a hole through seems promising, though. For you. It should lead to the other side of the city. It's not like you're able to open other doors around here. What can I make for you?
So this lockdown really is because of us?
Oh my, yes. Odin's grip on this realm is so firm, any outsider is considered a threat.
Sounds like an Odinism if I ever heard one.
I'll disinfect my tools. This axe just keeps getting stronger. Till we meet again! I'll heat up the forge. Nothing appeals to you? One less feathery spy.
Best of luck.
Any outsider is considered a threat. Is that to protect the dwarves?
It sounds like it. But knowing Odin, there's sure to be an ulterior motive.
Well, everyone's hiding on this side too.
Odin's occupation of this realm has its hooks in deep.
But there aren't any guards patrolling. We're clearly not a threat. Why hide?
Resist and you're made an example of, to keep the rest in line. Self-preservation can outweigh bravery for even the strongest of folk.
Fear keeps them safe and alive.
Tavern's gotta be around here somewhere. Maybe we can try knocking on some doors for directions. Keep moving. I think we need some special equipment to use this.
Careful!
Another of Cavassier's poems.
Look, over there. Look, over there. Hello? I think I see something. Sorry to bother you.
If you're selling something, please bugger off. If you're not selling something, please kindly bugger off.
This looks promising, right? Well, that's like a house. If he's here, maybe you should let me do the talking.
You?
Well, we don't want to intimidate him. You're tall as a tree and you have a severed head on your hip.
None taken. Fair point, though.
Very well.
Think that's him? Hello?
Watch yourselves. Apparently, there are intruders about.
Oh, that's us, I think.
Well, if you're planning on killing me, at least let me finish this song. That alarm was in just the perfect key.
We're just looking for a friend of ours named Derlin.
Well, we both know that's not true. Derlin's got no friends left. But if that's all you need, head out the back way there, and you'll see the safety office just across the river. Just don't go making trouble for the rest of us. And while you travel through this realm, maybe you could clean up the head's mess.
What mess?
Later, brother.
I wish to hear this mess.
The rig's in the bay. Why don't you ask the condescending skull?
Head, I've got skin. But he's right. I made a mistake. I'd have us shut them down.
Sorry, one more thing. Although, these are gifts I'm giving to you, so I shouldn't be sorry and you should be thankful. Anyways, here. Please be careful.
It's beautiful. Thanks, Sindri.
It is beautiful, isn't it? It's also very useful. You'll be able to find anything your heart desires with it.
Really?
As long as your heart desires the locations your father and you decide and plot to travel together, then yes.
It is a compass.
Ah, but a beautiful compass. Now scamper off.
Come. A boat cannot be far.
Huh. Earlier, Sindri made it sound like Durlan was some sort of rebellion leader. Doesn't sound like anyone's following him.
Was being the key word here, little brother.
I saw a dock back there. Maybe there's a boat we can use to get to Durlan's. There's a building just past these rocks behind me. Maybe we should head that way.
Ugh, those bloody mining rigs.
What about them?
The Skald is right to blame me for them. But my idea, if you've got the time, they're in the bay just beyond this tunnel.
Particularly appreciate us checking out the mining rigs in the lake to the right. You can see the smokestacks from here.
But if you don't want to explore now, it looks like Durlan's place is through that open gate to the left. So, which way do we go? We could prepare more before rescuing Tyr. Up to you. So we're going to Durlan's? Makes sense. We could always explore those mining rigs later. This is the safety office?
Well, the sign a hair's breadth away from a head injury up there certainly gives that impression.